Christmas won't be Christmas without any presents.
So dreadful to be poor.
I don't think it's fair for some girls to get lots of pretty things. And then other girls get nothing at all.
We have mother and father. And we have each other.
We don't have father. And we're not going to have father for a long time.
You know, my mother proposed having no presents this year is because it's going to be a hard winter for all. We ought to spend money for pleasure when our men are suffering so in the army. We should all make our little sacrifices and do so gladly. I'm afraid I don't.
What good's a fiver going to do to the army? I accept that we shouldn't get presents from Mother or you, but I do really want a new book. I've wanted one for ages.
I plan to spend mine on new music.
I shall get a new box of paints. I really need them.
Look, Mother didn't say anything about our money, so why don't we treat ourselves, have a little fun? I'm sure we've all earned it.
I know I do. Teaching those tiresome children all day when I'm longing to come home and enjoy myself.
You don't have half the hard time as I do. How would you like it being stuck in this house all day, not being able to get out and having to worry about this fussy old woman who's never satisfied? I don't know whether I want to fly out the window or cry.
It's naughty to worry, but I do think that washing dishes and tidying things up is the worst work in the world. It makes me so fed up. And my hands get so stiff that I can't practice well at all.
No! I don't believe any of you suffer as I do, for you don't have to go to school with awful girls who wind you up if you don't know your lessons, and laugh at your dresses, and label your father if he isn't rich, and insult you if your nose isn't pretty.
If you mean liable, then so what? But don't label Dad as if he was a pickle jar.
I know what I mean. And you needn't be satirical about it. It's proper to use good words and improve your vocabulary.
Don't peck at each other. Oh, wouldn't it be wonderful to have the money Dad lost when we were little?
Oh, how happy we'd be if we had no worries.
You said the other day you thought we were happier than celebrities. They're fighting and stressed all the time in spite of their money.
So I did, and I think that we are. But though we work hard, we make fun of ourselves. And we're a pretty jolly set, as Joe would say.
Joe does use such slang words. Don't, Joe. It's so boyish.
And that's why I do it.
I hate rude, unpleasant, unladylike girls.
And I hate unaffected, spoiled brats.
Hey, sit down. And you, sit.
Both to blame. Josephine, it didn't matter to act boyish when you were younger, but now that you're taller and know how to do your hair, you should remember you are a young lady now.
I'm not a young lady, and I'll wear my hair however I want to wear my hair. I don't want to be like you, prim and proper. Look at you, I want to be out there. I want to be with Dad. I don't want to be stuck here like a pokey old woman knitting him socks.
Poor Joe, it's too bad, but it can't be helped. So you must try to be contented by making your name boyish and playing brother to us girls.
But as for you, Amy, you're altogether too prim and proper. It's amusing now, but if you're not careful, you're going to an affected old goose. Mm. Look, I like your nice ways and refined way of speaking, but when you're not trying to be elegant, your absurd words are almost as silly as Joe's slang.
Joe's a tomboy. And Amy's a goose. Then what am I, please?
You're a deer, and nothing else.
some of my fibre.
No! I shall!
I'm the oldest!
Well, I'm the man of the house. Dad told me to look after Mum while he was away, so I'll get them.
I'll tell you what we'll do. Let's each get us something for Christmas and not get anything for ourselves.
You are good, Beth. What should we get her?
I shall get her a nice pair of gloves.
Boots.
Some handkerchiefs.
I shall get her a lovely little bottle of perfume. I know she likes it, and then I will still have money left over to buy my pencils.
And how should we give her these things?
Well, why don't we put them on the table, bring her in, and then she'll see the presents, like we used to do on our birthdays.
I used to be so frightened when it was my turn to sit in the chair with the crown on and see you guys come marching down with presents and kisses. The presents I liked, and the kisses. But it was really difficult for me to sit there, have you staring at me while I opened them.
Look, let's surprise Mum. Tomorrow we can go to town and buy all those presents, and we've got so much to do before we can sort out the Christmas show.
I don't intend to act anymore after this one. I'm getting too old for such things.
You won't stop as long as you're allowed to wear that pretty white gown with all that paper jewellery. You're the best actress we've got. Now, come on, Amy. Let's do that fainting scene and stop being as stiff as an old poker.
I can't help it! I never saw anyone faint before, and I don't choose to make myself all black and blue, tumbling flat as you do. No, if I can go down easily, I'll drop. And if I can't, I shall fall into a chair and be graceful. And I don't care if Hugo does come at me with a pistol.
Look, do what I do. Clasp your hands together like this and stagger forward, saying, Rodrigo, Rodrigo, save me! Ah!
Rodrigo, Rodrigo, save me, save me!
It's no use. Look, if the audience laugh at you on the night, don't blame me. Come on then, we need to do the witch's curse. Move this, we don't have any space. Come on. Right, now I need you to sit down here with a cauldron and pretend that you're singing to the spirits. Amy, where are those costumes that I told you to get?
What costumes are those?
The ones that I told you to get.
I forgot them.
Well, I have an idea. Excuse me, Beth. Why don't we use this wrap?
Oh, I like this.
Around you, like that.
Well, it's not as good as my costume, but where's yours?
It would have been with Amy's, but I can use this as a hat. If I tie it around my forehead.
Oh, right, cool. Now I need you to go on to the piano and go dun, 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 when I come in, because I'm the villain. Dun, dun. We ready?
Ready?
Yeah. Rather do Macbeth. If only we had a trapdoor like Banquo. I've always liked to kill someone. Is that a dagger I see?
I think this rather suits me as a bandana.
Nice to see you so merry, my girl.
Man, you're back!
How are you today?
Oh, Beth, did anyone call?
No. Meg, how's your cold, sweetheart?
Much better.
Joe? You look tired to death. Oh, come here. Come and give your mum a big hug. Oh. Now, I've got a surprise for you girls.
Oh, a card! A Christmas card!
Did you notice?
A Christmas card from your father with lots of wonderful wishes for Christmas and a special message for you girls.
It was so loving of father to go as a counsellor when he was too old to be drafted, not strong enough to be a soldier.
I wish I could go as a nurse or a journalist or anything, just so I could be near him.
Oh, but it must be so disagreeable to sleep in a tent, and to eat all sorts of nasty tasting foods, and to drink out of a tin mug.
When will he come home?
Not for a while, sweetheart. That is, unless he's sick. But he must stay and do his duty. And we won't expect him back, not a minute sooner. Right, let's have a look at this letter now. Right. Give them all of my dear love and a kiss. Tell them I think of them by day, pray for them by night, and find my best comfort in their affection at all times. A year seems very long to wait before I see them. But remind them that while we wait, we may all work at these, oh, your dad's writing. These hard days need not be wasted. Oh, my love, Dad, I am so proud of my little woman.
I'm a selfish girl. But I will truly try to be better so he won't be so disappointed in me.
I think too much of my looks and hate to work. But I won't anymore, not if I can help it.
Well, I just want to be a boy, but I'm going to start trying to do what Dad says and be a little woman.
How about you play us something, Beth?
It is Christmas after all. Come on.
Meg, you can have
it.
Us to read and love these books, but we must start at once. We used to be faithful about such things, but when Dad left and that terrible war business unsettled us, we've neglected many things. You can do as you please, but I shall keep my mind by my bed. Read a little every morning, for I know it will do me good. Where is Mum?
Oh, God only knows. Someone came knocking at the door for some money, and she went to get some cash to give him. You know your mother, so kind.
She'll be back soon, Helen. We must get everything ready. Mm. Where is Amy's present? The little perfume bottle.
She took it a minute ago to go and put a ribbon on it.
How nice my handkerchiefs look, don't they? Hannah washed and ironed them for me.
Oh, look, she's gone and put Mother on it instead of M. Marsh. How funny.
Is that wrong? I decided to do it that way because Meg's initials are M. March, and I didn't want anyone else to use them but Mum.
Don't you worry, dear. It's a pretty idea. Quite sensible, too, for no one will mistake them now. I will please her very much, I know. Quick, hide the basket. Mother's coming. Where have you been? What are you hiding behind your back?
Don't laugh at me, Jo. You see, I only meant for no one to know until the time came. I was so ashamed about my present after we were talking about being so good and reading Mommy's gift to us, so I went round the corner and got a new one. I exchanged it and I gave all my money for it, so I'm truly trying not to be selfish anymore. And I'm so glad that I did, because my present is so much nicer than yours.
Hannah, how is everything? Girls!
Mom!
Merry Christmas!
Merry Christmas!
Oh, so good to see you. Oh, this is beautiful. I'm so glad you've done all of this. Anyway, I've got something to talk to you about. Can you all come and sit down here with me for a while? Oh, look at this. Where did this come from?
Now then, while I was out, I came across a little boy begging in the streets. He told me that his mum had just had a newborn baby and they had no food. And they were so cold, they all had to huddle up together because the heating wasn't working. Isn't that awful? Anyway, I thought about an idea. How about we give them our breakfast for a Christmas present?
Well, I'm so glad you told us before we'd begun.
May I help bring the food to the children?
Wonderful.
I'll bring the butter.
Right, thank you. Come on, everyone. Hannah, let's get all the bags together and put some bread in there and all these fruit and everything. We can help them and then we can come back and have what's left for breakfast. And then we'll make it up for dinner. How's that? Wonderful.
And what about this?
What's there? Beautiful idea. Okay, everyone, go and get your coats and scarves. It's very cold out there. Come on.
Sheaves on the water.